Good morning everyone. Today we are going to see an introduction on branch and bound technique, and we are going to solve an application related to this technique. Today we are going to see an assignment problem and going to solve by using a branch and bound technique. Let's see how to solve it. Introduction to branch and bound. In this method, a space tree of all possible solutions is generated. We will be constructing a tree with all possible solutions. Then partitioning or branching is done at each node of the tree. We compute a bound value at each node. It may be a lower bound or an upper bound based on our problem. We then compare a node bound value with the value of best solution seen so far. Each time we compare a node bound value with the value of the best solution obtained until now. If the bound value of the sum node is not better than the best solution, then the corresponding is not expanded further. That particular node is said to be a non-promising node, which we are meant for extension or moving for a further iteration. It is said to be a promising node. This is the principal idea of branch and bound technique. Here we will be using two strategies. One is said to be a LIFO search and another is said to be a FIFO search. LIFO search means last in first out. We will be using a stack data structure. FIFO means first in first out. We will be using a queue data structure. Now let's move to a assignment problem. We can see how to solve an assignment problem by using a branch and bound technique. Yes, that's what here clearly explained, what is mean by a non-promising node and what is mean by a promising node. Yes, problem statement for assignment problem. There are n people to whom n job ought to be assigned so that the total cost of the assignment should be minimum, that is small as possible. The assignment problem is specified by n into n matrix. So here will be a person, here will be a job. For each person, the job allotment payment will be allotted here. Yes, so in each row has to be selected in such a way that no two selected element are in the same column and the sum is smallest as far as possible at the end of the problem. See, this is the problem given to us. Let's see how to solve this problem by using a branch and bound technique. So this is the problem. Let's see how to solve. First, we have to create a single node which have a minimum value of all these three. Okay. So start. We have to start with the why it is a lower bound in this assignment problem, because the problem have to yield a minimum value. So we are going the calculation based on our lower bound. So based on our table, in each row we have to take a minimum value from each row. You don't want to consider whether it is from a same row or same column. You have to just take a minimum value from each row for the starting point. So for person 1, the first row, it is the minimum value is 2. For person B, the minimum value is 3. For person C, the minimum value is 1. For person D, the minimum value is 4. These two are come in the same column. So you don't want to need not to worry. At the end of the problem, we will be allocating in a proper manner. Now, initially while starting, if it is in same column, we don't want to consider it. Just you have to take a minimum value from each row. So 2 plus 3 plus 1 plus 4. Yes. So it is 10. 2 plus 3 plus 1 plus 4 is 10. Now we will be allocating a job for a person A alone. We will not consider a person B, C and D for the consideration. So person A may have a first job also. So first we have a calculation based on the first job. So for person A, we will be allocating a first job. So we can see how to calculate a lower bound for it. So this is our matrix table. For a person A, we are allocating a first job. So this is our first job column. Yes, for person A, first job means 10. You have to compulsorily have to mark this as 10. And from all the, for person B, C and D, you have to take a minimum, just a minimum value. Don't want to consider anything. So 10 plus 3 plus 1 plus 4. So the lower bound will be 18. For person A, the first job, the lower bound is 18. Now the same way, you have to calculate it for a person A with a job 2. Yes, A with job 2. You have to calculate the lower bound. So lower bound calculation, this is a matrix. So this is the job 2 column. This is a person A. So job 2 will, for job 2, person A, it is 2. So 2. And the remaining you should not take from this particular column alone. You have to take from the column 1, 3 and 4. You have to take a minimum value from that particular thing. So 3 plus 1 plus 4. Yes. So next, for person A, the third job. So the lower bound calculation for person A, this is the third job column. So for person A, the job 3 is 7. So 7. For B, C and D, you can take a values from job 1, 2, 1, 4. For 1, 2, 1, 4, if you are considering 4 is minimum, so it is 4. 5, 8 and 8, the values, which one is minimum? 5, so it is 5. 7, 6 and 4, only option is there. 7, 6 and 4, the value is minimum is 4. So it is taken. Now for a job person A with job 4 calculation. So person A, job 4 calculation, we have to calculate the lower bound. It is a matrix. So job 4 column is the last column. So this is a person A. So you should not consider this for the person B, C and D. So first person A is 8. So that particular column will be blocked. For B, 6, 4, 3 only is available, so it is minimum is 3. For C, 5, 8 and 1 is minimum, so it is taken. For 6, for person D, 7, 6 and 10 only is available, so 6, so it is 6. The value is 18. So we have, now we have to consider which is a promising node and which is not a promising node. Further, we are to, from which node we are going to proceed is said to be a promising node. Here now we have to consider a minimum value from these four category. What is the minimum value here? It is 10. So from this particular 10, we will be proceeding our B allocation. Yes. So this is our starting node. We have calculated our A value, which is the minimum. The lower bound 10 is minimum. So it will all A1, A3 and A4 will be a non-promising. For A, job 2 is allocated. For B, C and D, the remaining job only can be allocated. We cannot allocate the job 2 for the B, C and D. Yes. So for B, we are trying with the first job. Again, the lower bound calculation. In lower bound calculation, what happened? Already the A have booked with the column 2, job 2. So we cannot use the column 2. Now B is booked with the column 1. So B, column 1, the value is 6. So 2 is already allocated. It is A value 2 plus. Now we are trying for the job 1 for B. So it is 6. C can allocate from job 3 and job 4. So 1 and 8 compare. 1 is minimum, so 1 is taken. For a person D, 10 and 4, we are comparing. So which one is minimum? 4. So we have taken 4. So the lower bound for a person B, 1 job is 13. Yes. Now we cannot allocate a job 2 for B. So now we are moving for a job 3. Whether it can be suited for person B. So we have to calculate a lower bound. So 2 is allocated already for A, so it is blocked. Now we are trying with the B for job 3 for B. So person B, job 3 is 3. So 2 is already allocated plus 3. C is for job 1 and 4. So 5 plus 8. So it is 5 minimum. So taken. Now for job person D, 7 and 4. Minimum is 4. So it is taken. Now we will be calculating the same for person for B for 4th job. We are trying for 4th job. So this job 2 is allocated for A, so we cannot touch that. So B is trying for 4th job. So B, person B, 4th job, the 4th value, it is 7. So 2 plus 7. For C, job 1 and 3 is compared. Which one is minimum? Yes, this one is minimum. So 1 is taken. So 7 and 10. So which is minimum? 7. So it is taken. We have calculated. Now again you have to find the promising node and non-promising node from this. Yes, so for A, 2 is allocated. For B, see B1, B3 and B4. Which one is minimum? B1 is minimum. So for B, 1 will be allocated. So C can allocate only 3 or 4. So if person 3 is allocated with the job 3, means obviously the job D should be allocated for job 4 to a D. Yes, if a person C is allocated with the job 4, means obviously it is said that the D should allocate with the 3rd. So we will be having a same calculation here. So now we are trying with job 3 for C and job 4 for D. So 2 is already allocated, the value 6 is already allocated for B. So now job 3, person 3 with job 3, so 1 will be here. And for person D, 4th job, so person D, 4th job, the value is 4. So the value will be, lower bound will be 13. Now in reverse, vice versa, C is 4 and D is 3. That only the option we have, right? So lower bound, 2 is already allocated. Job 2 is already allocated. So the value of that particular will be A value. For B also we have allocated job 1. So job 1 value will be 6. Yes, now C. For C we are trying with the 4. So the value is 8. So 8. For D the value is 10. Job 3, it is 10. So calculation 26. We have to compare this lower bound and this lower bound, which is the better thing. This is the better thing. So for A, the job, so for job 2 is allocated to A, for job 1 is allocated to B, job 3 is allocated to C, job D is allocated, job 4 is allocated to a D. So this is our lower bound calculation. Based on this, we have retrieved our answer. Yes. So A is 2, B is 1, C is 3 and D is our 4. So this is our final answer. So it is a solution. Why it is a solution? Because we got a minimum value for each column as much as possible. No value is selected under same column. See, for A it is 2, B is 1, C is 3 and D is 4. So we got a final answer. If you have any doubt on this particular problem, please contact me or comment me.